I want to take a moment to address a theory about the Haunted Mansion that's been going around for quite some time. Some of you might have seen where I wrote about this previously, but plenty of people seem to have not gotten the message. I don't have that big of a platform. Well, we're going to do this in video form now. Okay, this theory says that in the Haunted Mansion, every time you go on there, you die. How do you die? This theory says you die when you fall out the window of the Haunted Mansion after encountering the ghosts in the attic, whether that's just the bride or if it's the bride and the hatbox ghost. This is how this theory goes. Well, I'm going to go through and show you why that's probably not the case. Not long after the Haunted Mansion opened in Anaheim, Disney put out two different records that told the story of the Haunted Mansion, went through scene by scene, room by room, included the ghosts from those rooms. They put a character in there, whether it was the person speaking or whether it was a couple of teenagers who wandered in there by mistake. One of these actually starred Ron Howard as one of the teenagers. It was aimed at more of a preteen to adult audience. And the other was aimed at a younger audience. That was the one that I had, actually, when I was a kid. It was not a long playing record. It was, you know, this size. And the story was on one side and the song was on the other side. We'll come back to the song. On both of these records, in both of these stories, it is explained specifically how the character goes from the attic onto a balcony, an outdoor balcony, and then down. One of them goes off the balcony and climbs down a tree. That was in the one I had. And in the other one, they actually go down some stairs. It says specifically that they go down stairs. Don't believe me? Here's the audio.
We're trapped. There's no way out.
Hold the candles. I'll try to open this window. Come on. We're in luck. There's a balcony out here. Watch your step. The rain's made everything slippery.
The candles went out again.
Just leave them. We're outside now. Everything's going to be okay. There's some steps down at the far end.
But they lead to the graveyard.
Come on, it's the only way.
Our adventurous pair descended the steps to the ground level.
And here's the audio for the one that's aimed at little kids.
I climbed out of a window and onto a balcony, then down a tree and was greatly relieved to be out of that house. Now I had another problem. I was out of the house, but in the graveyard.
So, at the very least, we can say that Disney as an overall company was not really on board with the whole you fell off of out the window or off the balcony and die thing. That's not what Disney as a company was into. Otherwise, they would have put it in these record albums, right? Let's look at the song that was on the other side of that record. Story and song. On the other side of that story was Grim Grinning Ghosts. Most of the lyrics are just about, hey, these are happy-go-lucky ghosts, and they show up, Grim Grinning Ghosts come out to socialize. But in the final verse, it directly addresses the visitors and gives some very specific rules for how you might join them and become one of them. Let's have a listen.
If you would like to join our jamboree, there's a simple rule that's compulsory. Mortals pay a token fee. Rest in peace, the haunting's free. So hurry back, we would like your company.
That if, right there at the beginning, that's doing a lot of lifting, isn't it? If you would like to join our jamboree, here's what you have to do. Mortals pay a token fee. The token they pay is with their life. So hurry back. Rest in peace, the haunting's free, so hurry back. We'd like your company. Why would they sing this to us after we've already died on property at the Haunted Mansion? You see, typically, ghosts don't get to move other places after they die. The person dies, and that's the general area where the ghost hangs out. So, how can we leave? How could we hurry back, as we are entreated to do by little Leota on our way out? And if we're ghosts, why are we being haunted by the hitchhiking ghosts? Ghosts don't haunt other ghosts. And we are told directly that that's what they are doing. We are told directly that the hitchhiking ghosts are going to haunt us until we return. That's what the ghost host tells us.
Beware of hitchhiking ghosts. They have selected you to fill our quota, and they'll haunt you until you return.
Ghosts don't haunt other ghosts. And if we are dead, and therefore ghosts, we shouldn't be able to leave and go home. We shouldn't have to go fetch our death certificate and bring it back. That would be handled for us. And you can't say that Disney is against having death in their rides, because Mr. Toad's Wild Ride, you drive right into an oncoming train and then go to hell. They were okay with that. So they were okay with having death in their rides. That's not the problem. The problem is that they just didn't do it in this case. So, next time somebody tells you, oh, did you know you die inside the haunted, no, you don't. The story and song records say that you don't. Grim Grinning Ghosts is strong evidence that you don't. And the general rules around ghosthood in our culture suggest that you don't. Sorry, I mean, it's a fun little theory, but it just doesn't hold much water when you look at the actual evidence.